good old 80s classic right there. Fistful of Diamonds by none other than the shock rockers, W.A.S.P. Still some pretty good stuff, you know, some good, some of those old records never get old, man. They always sound good. But nevertheless, that's actually one of the theme songs of our show this evening. We want to talk about some of the greed that's going on, just overall. We've seen a lot of good reports from people like David Icke and Mark Dice and others regarding the absolute corruption and outright cultural Marxist manipulation and through subjugation of music. I mean, they've really have hammered some of this stuff. Recently, I posted a story. A former BET MTV executive said, yes, there is definitely an agenda on, and they purposely designed some of the videos to do just that. Which, again, this is very disturbing because this is why I say parents really need to start listening to what their kids are doing. For example, I remember my folks making comments when I was younger that they should have taken more time to listen to my music to see what the hell I was listening to. Me personally, because of the fact that I'm, you know, obviously a little bit above the normal average guy. I don't worry about fucking stupid Bengals games and things of that nature. I was able to listen to a lot of stuff myself. Yeah, you know, a lot of us, especially us guys, we're mainly into the music, you know. Unless it's got some shocking lyrics to it, whatever, we don't really give a shit. And a lot of us guys, who gives a fuck about ballads? Until you realize later on that chicks love that shit. So bands like Journey get into a little bit because obviously you're going to have more fun with chicks. But, you know, and also when you do have one that really reaches out, grabs your heart, you find the right ballad and maybe, you know, dedicate that song to her or whatever the case may be when you're in your teenage years. These are a definite must. And so this is how you, you know, you get your coming of age type of stuff going on. And of course, later on, if you are a musician, you can appreciate the artistry that goes into making a really great ballad. The music, maybe the solos, especially the lyrics. The lyrics are most important. But anyways, but the music industry has been totally manipulated in many different ways. In the mid to late 90s, Dayton was being looked at as possibly the next Seattle. I mean, you have bands like The Breeders that had come out, and they had a hit with Cannonball. With Kim and Kelly Deal, both being from Dayton. Matter of fact, I used to work with a guy whose nephew was the drummer in the Breeders at one time. Just other good talent that had come out of the area that had maybe have gone to other places. For example, there was a band in Cincinnati called Still Rain, and three of those members ended up becoming members of the new metal movement. Matter of fact, one of them I do believe might have been the drummer in Godsmack on their first album. And another guy was the guitarist, I think, for Double Drive, and I think the bass player was in another new metal band as well. But again, a lot of these guys didn't last very long. Godsmack and arguably Seven Dust are probably one of the few bands of that era that is actually still not only sellable, but also very bankable overall, especially Godsmack. They're definitely, but that's all Sully Erna. That's another W.A.S.P., Blackie Lawless, Motorhead, Lemmy Kilmister, where the main guy is the band and everybody else are just, you know, fill-in players. But nevertheless. But like I said, when I play Fistful of Diamonds, you know, it's not just the music industry, it's a situation, but just the greed in general. Remember what Tony Montana's mentor said in Scarface? He says, you know, rule number one, don't get high on your own supply. And then also said the second one, he said, don't underestimate the other guy's greed. Yeah, well, that's definitely a situation there. A lot of the music videos you see are so getting crappy, I mean, anymore. I mean, arguably, I have to say Fifth Harmony is probably the hottest-looking girl group since Exposé. My God, that Worth It video is just absolutely just, they captured the best they could get of those girls in that particular video, man. I mean, my God. Now, every single one of those girls is drop-dead gorgeous and may have something the other one doesn't have. But, you know, whenever you see a group like that, the first thing you try to do is locate who the lead member is and then try to pull them out of the group, just like they did with Justin Timberlake with NSYNC. So that's what they first thing to do. That was one of the good things about the Beatles is the fact that even though John founded the Beatles initially, even though Ringo and George were still respectable members of the Fab Four, at least the main lead duties are between John and Paul, so they couldn't separate them. They had to have them both. Same with Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley with Kiss, you know, same way. Lars Ulrich and James Hetfield and Metallica. As long as those two main members are there, nobody else matters. But anyway, a lot of the country videos you see now, a lot of the guys, they have two types of attributes that seem to be commonplace. Obviously, they all got medium builds now. They're all trying to beef up a little bit. But the biggest thing I noticed, which is very concerning, is this constant tattooing. They're going for the skanks, and I haven't seen any country stars with a tattoo on the neck yet. But you're getting a lot of tribal lines and fire legs and stupid shit like that. I remember when James Hetfield started tattooing himself for Metallica. I said, "What a waste, man!" I said, "You know, you don't have to fucking have a tattoo to be a hardcore dude." I mean, Metallica was the symbol of metal for a long time. I mean, just seeing James Hetfield in black with his wristbands on, hunched in front of the microphone like he does, playing his guitar, about all you need, man. I mean, literally, that's almost the equivalent of taking a tennis racket and standing in front of a long view mirror. But I mean, nevertheless, there's a certain image and stance, you know, it kind of goes with certain genres, and that's definitely one of them. Like D.D. Ramone playing his guitar, you know, slung down damn near between his knees. I mean, that was part of his trademark. But anyways, but I'm really concerned about all the country stuff because of the fact that it's becoming more pop than country. And at the same time, another problem that you have is the tattooing is definitely a problem. Because everybody's going to think that's freaking cool. The problem with tattoos are, yeah, it does make you look more unique. The problem is that's the easier way to identify you, whether it's to law enforcement or to the police state in which we are sliding into. So while you're worrying about your spring breakdown or you're worrying about any Jason Aldean song that really gets you going, man, just remember, when you go and get that tattoo done, it's very hard to get rid of. And a lot of people I've talked to afterwards who had a tattoo regret them. And thankfully, they have in places that hopefully they can be easily concealed, because in some places, it will affect your job. Ain't getting a job. So, any of you dumb fucks that want to have a tattoo on your neck because you got your kid's name on or some shit, or these dumb bitches that basically are essentially slaves and have become someone's property, you're going to have to live with that shit the rest of your life. So, think about that before you definitely jump into it, nevertheless. Okay, so I do have some hot new artists that are up and coming that I'm going to be featuring on the show here pretty soon when I get everything retooled. Like I said, we got a whole new format that we're putting together for the show. I may beta test a couple spots along the way with some of my guest hosts because of the fact that actually all of my hosts have been doing a fantastic job, and looking forward again to all of your guys' inputs and comments on the show page as well as whatever. Also, so far, of the guest hosts that you have heard, please leave us feedback, whether via Twitter or at Sonny Thomas Show or hashtag Sonny Thomas Show. Tell us which guest host that you've really enjoyed, not only just maybe style of delivery, tone of voice, or just content. Let me know which ones that you think that you thought were great, not so great. Tell me why. Thanks again to Catastrophe, Corinne Smith, Dan Sullivan, and also we got other great hosts coming up. We're going to have Nathan Lawrenson from the Bat of New Orleans Radio. He's going to be doing a show for us in September. Also, we got to work out the mechanics behind it, but I'm very honored to say that highly award-winning film documentary filmmaker Dennis Wise of the controversial but yes much needed to be done work Adolf Hitler, The Greatest Story Never Told. Also, he has a documentary he's been putting out about the New World Order. Definitely want to check that out. Go to thegreateststorynevertold.tv. Download the free double album soundtrack album at thegreateststorynevertold.tv and download it for yourself. And some of the tracks from that soundtrack you've been hearing on a lot of commercials. Matter of fact, the main theme song of the beginning of the documentary has also recently been used in the Game of War Fire Age 30-second commercial, where they show them building the castle and throwing the firebombs on it. Shit, that song you're hearing in the background is the main theme from Adolf Hitler, The Greatest Story Never Told. So that track is also becoming very, very popular. But nevertheless, YouTube is still trying to fuck him on copyright issues. Nevertheless, I nearly have the whole documentary formatted and ready to go for broadcast in the Southwest Ohio area. So we're looking forward to that. I haven't settled on a date yet. I've had some mechanical issues with software, so I may be delayed. I was hoping to do something maybe for September 1st, which was the day that the Nazis invaded Poland at 4:45 in the morning. If not, we're looking at some other dates in Germany or Nazi Germany history, just because I'm a history buff, and since this particular topic is about Nazi Germany, we look at particular dates of relevance, whether it's dates of victory for Germany or dates of victory for the Allies or whatever the case may be. But the bottom line is we've been finding out more and more every day that the Allies have been lying to us the whole time and are still lying to this day. Some of it's common knowledge. Some of it is just now starting to creep out. But nevertheless, we've got a lot of good information. So essentially kind of like Fox News, you watch, you decide. Do yourself a favor, at least watch it at least once, maybe twice, because it is long and epic. But the bottom line is, just like 9/11, it does make you think. And that's what we do here on the Sonny Thomas Show. So make sure you follow us on Facebook.com/Sonny Thomas Show, at Twitter @SonnyThomasShow. Also follow us for Truth Emerges Radio on Facebook, Truth Emerges RDO, and @TruthEmergesRDO on Twitter. So again, let me know which guest host you've heard so far that you like the best, who's most informative, who's got the best personality, maybe what you don't like. I'd really appreciate your feedback. But I want to thank all of my guest hosts, regardless, for filling in during my short sabbatical while I'm retooling the show and enjoying a little time off. So having some good stuff. So lots of my hot thing. We'll be catching you soon. And hope you enjoyed checking out W.A.S.P. Fistful of Diamonds. Tell me that don't hit the spot.